The Burbank High School Animation Program welcomes you to the 9th Annual Bash. This is where we proudly feature our best animated shorts completed this school year and celebrate our mentorship and partnership activities with Nickelodeon. Special to the program this year are inspirational messages from our alumni, all to support our work and dreams in this extraordinary pandemic year. First, a little bit about our program. The Burbank Animation Program offers up to 4 years of classes that build a portfolio in animation-related skills and offers experiences to broaden our vision and community. We work in a beautiful studio with a full digital lab, sound studio, and VR workstation. Physical media, filming, sets, and traditional arts complement our 2D and 3D skill building. Animation 2, students specialize in longer, semester-long projects, working toward personal interests and goals. Our third year is entertainment arts, exploring how animation-related skills are used beyond the story. And finally, our seniors work on capstone projects that show their culmination of personal style and depth of concept. We are supported by amazing opportunities from guest artists and studio and college visits. We enjoy sharing our talents with the school and community to bring beauty to spaces and events. Each year, we will have a select number of student work with professionals in the Nickelodeon Mentorship Program, honing an original animated short. And a fun bonus is celebrating our work in festivals and screenings. We enjoy creating, and most of all, supporting the personal artistic journey of each of us. If you enjoy drawing, storytelling, and designing, we hope you consider joining us.
Hi, my name is Carson Smith, and I head up Community Efforts for Nickelodeon. This is the 10th year that we've partnered with Burbank High School, and the 10th year of our mentorship program, which pairs Nickelodeon employees with animation students from Burbank High's animation program. But this year is different because these students, these aspiring storytellers, have been able in the middle of a global pandemic to create these short films. It's shown a great deal of resilience, determination, and ultimately creativity. So hats off to them. And also a big nod to our mentors who once again stepped up to the plate to help these young people realize their dreams. Thanks. Enjoy the show.
Yes, first place. Let's go. I'm a boss. Oh, we're rolling. Ow! Yay! All right. Hey guys. It's Jeremy Mejia. I'm a senior at Burbank High School, class animation 2, count 2. And you're watching this because you guys are about to see my latest animation called The Top Hat Trials. The Top Hat Trials is about three young teenagers, one of them who is my best friend, Cole, your awesome buddy. They're on a voyage to stop the evil Master Hatters, from destroying the world and stuff, using top hats, because it's called the Top Hat Trials. They're using, that's the whole gimmick, Top Hats. This is all made in pencil and paper, all of it, with a notebook and a lead pencil, multiple lead pencils, actually, multiple notebooks. So everything you're about to see was made with these hands. No digital nothing, just pure skill and dedication. I mentioned I'm a senior, I'm going to be leaving high school after this, and I'm going to be going to a college. I'm going to be pursuing in animation, the thing that, the entire reason why I'm here. I'm also thinking about minoring in computer science so I can create, cool video games, stuff like that. I don't know, maybe become an indie. I don't know, who knows. People I have to thank. I have Mrs. Pickett to thank, amazing animation teacher. She's awesome, she's energetic. She's someone that I wish I could be 24/7 because I'm usually depressed. I also have the Nickelodeon mentors to thank, even though they put a bunch of work on me. And let me tell you, pencil paper animation ain't easy, especially with the life you live. Lastly, the people I have to thank the most, the people that I wouldn't even be here without them, is my team. Christopher, Jason, Cole, I thank you guys a whole bunch. I love you all. I would have never gone here without you guys, because, I mean, this is big, and you guys kept motivating me to keep drawing and stuff, so I have you guys to thank. So you guys are technically a part of this success. So let's get on with the animation.
Are you forgetting someone?
What? Cartoon Jeremy, what are you doing here? I'm doing the intro for the bash.
Well, I was gonna tell you that.
Now get off, Cole! I'm on a Zoom meeting.
Sorry.
You done?
You're forgetting to thank me.
Thank you. What have you done?
Well, who's the one that stopped you from losing your sanity?
You know,
on multiple occasions.
Thank you, Cartoon Jeremy.
Much appreciated. Woo!
So, if you're watching this animation, prepare to lose some brain cells. As today, we're going on an adventure featuring everyone's favorite screw-up, Cole.
This is the Top Hat Trials!
Hey, where's that music coming from?
Not important.
Oh, okay.
Meet our heroes, Cole, Natalie, and Jake. Our heroes are walking about the fields of Top Hat Tracks on their way to stop the five Master Hatters.
So, you guys ready to stop the Master Hatters?
You bet. This will be exciting. Kind of nerve-wracking, to be honest.
Not to worry, Nat. If we do get in a jam, me and Cole are right beside you.
Why does that not comfort me?
Yeah, don't count me on that whole protecting stuff.
Well, you can count on me, right, Nat? Nat?
Huh?
Uh-oh. Is that...
Yes, the first Master Hatter.
Call me... Snatch.
Why Snatch, though? Literally any other name would have been cooler.
Cause I like to snatch people's cash. Anyways, you three are the heroes that are supposed to stop me.
I don't fully count as a human being.
Silence! Now, even if you do become a threat to me, I have someone who can take care of you later!
So what's gonna happen now? A huge mini-boss is gonna appear behind us?
Thank you.
really. They had to pick this song?
Hey, Nat? Remember when I said I was gonna protect you?
Yeah?
Yeah, I changed my mind.
Let's do this.
Giant anime spider.
Alright. You wanna play? Let's play.
That's bad!
Finale, right? Too soon.
Too soon.
Just barely below average. Aw, it's these little guys.
Hey, Jake, that was very brave of you to, you know, save us like that.
Oh, it was nothing, really.
Right. Hey, we cool?
You kidding? You're the only girl that's ever lied to me, for sure!
Man, this is pretty good for a pilot episode, right?
Hey, and if we're lucky, we'll probably get our own series. Right, Jeremy?
Maybe. Wait, hold up, I didn't say you guys would have a show.
Yay!
We're getting a show! We're getting a show!
Pray for me.
Better, but could be worse.
Hey there, my name is Zare Oganessian, and I'm a production manager at DreamWorks Animation TV. I've worked on Netflix's Spirit Riding Free, and I'm currently on an unannounced project, eagerly waiting for it to be released. When I was in Burbank High, I took 2 years of Miss Pickett's animation classes in my junior and senior year, and I graduated in 2011, exactly a decade ago. But after those classes, I couldn't imagine working in any other field. I wanted to be a part of that fun and creativity. And when I graduated, I went to Glendale Community College, where I was able to take additional art classes and continue to develop my skills until I transferred over to Woodbury University. And there I majored in animation and was able to meet classmates who were super passionate about animation and who really wanted to work in the industry. I was inspired to push myself even harder. In school, I learned that you have to fight for yourself and really have the drive and perseverance to set and follow through with all of your goals that you set up, because nobody is going to do it for you. And in school, I realized that I love working as a team, helping bring people together to help produce something, help create something. And that's when I realized I wanted to be in production. So after graduating Woodbury, I had a short internship at Stupid Buddy Studios, where I helped out with a few shows, and then I started as a production assistant at DreamWorks on Spirit. And since then, I've just been learning and growing and moving up in production. I was promoted to a production coordinator, then supervisor, and now manager. And production is essentially the glue that binds all the different departments together. We help communicate between everybody among all the teams and make sure that everybody has what they need and they're on schedule and they're able to produce the show. And I love it. I love being a part of this team and finding creative problem-solving methods, having the chance to see a project from script all the way to post-production. It's really rewarding and exciting. And yeah, if I were to give any kind of advice to aspiring animation people, it would be to believe in yourself, but to also know that you're always going to be learning and growing. So taking that confidence and that openness for growth and combining it with a passion for animation and a positive attitude is going to get you really far in the industry. 10 years ago, I was where you are now, and today I'm working at an amazing animation studio surrounded by the nicest people, and I'm working to help produce a show that's so funny and really beautiful. And if I can do it, so can you.
Hey, I'm Max Water from Animation One. My animation is a stop motion that I made to the song I've Got Some Falling to Do from Lemon Demon. All pieces of it were painstakingly cut out by hand and moved inch by inch by me. It was a very interesting process for me since, in general, this was my second animation I've ever made, plus my first time doing stop motion. So there definitely was a learning curve. There isn't really a message behind it. I just thought it's a fun song and the lyrics are, I just enjoy the lyrics a lot. As a person, I'm really interested in all aspects of film, including animation and the creation of all things, but I'm gearing towards a more of an art design since I really enjoy designing things and making props for things. Anyway, I hope you enjoy my animation.
I just wanted to congratulate you on your project. You did an awesome job and you should be really proud. I wish you luck on all of your future endeavors and can't wait to see what you do next.
Hi, my name is Danielle Tomita and I am in advanced animation. My partner, Emily Snyder, and I created an animation to show the effects of drug addiction. The story, She, follows a man struggling to get the thought of drugs off his mind, only leading to his downfall. The woman you'll see throughout the animation represents his temptation for drugs. In the future, I hope to work in TV or movie animation as a storyboard artist or in the character design department. I hope you enjoy our animation.
Drops his kids off at school, and he's thinking of you. Like all of us do. Sends his assistant for coffee in the afternoon, around 1:32. He knows what to do. She lives in daydreams with me. She's the first one that I see, and I don't know why. I don't know who she is. She thank you.
baby. I'm coming to you from my studio-ish space. It's kind of crazy right now because I'm in the middle of making a lot of things. So I graduated Burbank High School in 2017. I am a graduating senior at University of California, San Diego. I study both business and design, and I just accepted a full-time position at Nickelodeon in the Talent Development and Outreach Program, where we work with the Nickelodeon Artist Program and Nickelodeon Writing Programs. So I've been an intern with Nickelodeon for the past like 2 years. I started a couple years ago in the summer between my sophomore and junior year, and that door was completely open because of work I did with Ms. Pickett, actually. So for those of you who've been part of the Nickelodeon Mentorship Program, that's how I first got to know people at Nickelodeon. And in that time, I was able to talk with Carson and just get a lowdown on what the whole internship program looks like. So that summer, the summer between my sophomore and junior year, I was just shooting out emails, applying to like, I think I applied to over 70 internships. And you know, it was really crazy doing that whole process. Got a lot of rejections, but then I got these calls from Nickelodeon. And so I went through that whole process. I think it was like six different rounds of interviews, and I was able to become a Nickturn. So that summer really did change pretty much everything for me. I was able to start networking and getting to know people, and really like networking is just a funny word for making friends and meeting mentors in the industry. And that's really what I was doing for the past like 2 years. I guess like the best advice that I got was to just make yourself indispensable to your team. And that's like, I took it and ran with it. I basically ran the social media for the Nickelodeon Artist Program, growing us from like 8K to 20K followers now. And that was pretty much my thing. So I used a lot of the things that you learn in Ms. Pickett's class, actually, like just in After Effects and like basics of just like art making. I used it pretty much every day in my work. I basically was creating like mini animations for our submission periods and everything. And that's how I was able to like make myself indispensable because of the skills that I learned with Ms. Pickett. Right now it is a lot of just like assistant work, but then also working with the social media team and creating like new creative campaigns for them. As an intern, you get so many cool opportunities. One of the opportunities that we have right now is to work with the entire intern team to pitch a show. So we're actually pitching my show idea in a few weeks. We're in development right now, which is super fun. But that's really the cool thing about Nickelodeon, has been having the opportunity to just build upon skills that I'd already learned all the way in high school, which you all are like doing it right now, build upon those skills and like meeting new people in ways that make it so that I can, you know, get to where I am now. I guess the main things that I wanted to like capitalize on are, make sure that you're being as friendly as possible to everyone you meet. I think that that's one of the most undervalued things, no matter what your profession is. Making friends, especially art world friends, because art world friends are the most fun. Making friends in entertainment, if that's what you want to go into, because people will remember you. If you were just a good friend and a good person, they'll remember like, okay, this person was a great team player. They did a lot of stuff. And you know what? It was just easy to work with them. And that was something that's like feedback that I've gotten a lot, is just you did your work and you were super friendly, easy to work with. So that's one thing that like, you're going to hear it a lot, but it's definitely, definitely true. Outside of Nickelodeon, I also like run my own small business. That's why you see like socks and stuff in the background. There's so much opportunity to do creative stuff both in and out of your like traditional job, if that's what you want to go into. So just like good luck, you guys, and I'm just excited for you all. Congratulations on everything with the bash and getting done some of your first animations. That's so impressive, like so cool. I cannot wait to see everything, but have a great one, guys.
Hi, my name is Aaron Moran-Guillen, and I am an Animation 1. My film's name is Primitive. It's about a greedy explorer who, while hunting for treasure, finds a valuable cave painting and snatches the poor clueless drawings from their cozy cave. I think the most enjoyable part for me while working for this project was experimenting with squash and stretch techniques. It was really fun to see what I could do and, you know, what I was capable of. The hardest obstacle I had while making this film was having to deal with some technical difficulties with the program I was using. It was really buggy, and I had to keep redoing some frames because the program would keep deleting them for no reason. It was a really annoying and tedious bug. I'm hoping to get a career in storyboarding. I love telling stories, and I think it's my best area. Anyway, I hope you enjoy my animation.
Just wanted to say congratulations to our mentee, Louisa. She finished the program and has made an incredible animation, and I think it shows from all the hard work that she's put into it. She always comes with just more stuff than she's supposed to have done. She blew us away every single time we met with her with just how much she was able to get done. And so I think as she keeps going forward, she's going to have no problems turning this into a career. She's wonderful, and I think you guys are going to be excited about her movie.
Hi, my name is Louisa Ulmer, and I'm currently a junior at Burbank High, and I'm in Ms. Pickett's Animation 2 class. My short film is called Torn. It revolves around this humanoid girl being who has been living in the forest for a very long time and has sort of grown into the forest. And she then one day sees something new and has to decide if she wants to follow it out of the forest or not. The idea stems from real life experiences with risk-taking or decision-making and sometimes being overwhelmed by those decisions. In the future, I plan to take more art courses, including in high school and in college. I'm very interested in concept art, illustration, and the idea of designing concept art or art directing. That's everything. Thank you so much.
this thing on? Yeah, it's on. So I'm gonna start this interview off with a horse right here, with a lamb. Isn't that cool? What's up, guys? My name is Hybrid Sarkisian, and I graduated Burbank in the year of 2011, and went to PCC, and then took a bunch of art classes. I was originally studying animation, and I went to Woodbury for that too, and got to meet a bunch of animators and character designers over at Disney. And I realized that I took a couple tours, and I realized that cubicle life is not my style, you know? So I like to be free. I'm actually at my job site, check it out, painting these murals. When I was at Woodbury, I decided to take the leap and see if I can do my own thing. While I was at school in Woodbury, I was working at a company called Grosh. It was a backdrop painting company. You might know them from Americana, the movie theater. As soon as you enter that humongous painting up on top, we do things like that for plays and what's not. So I was there for 4 years, and then while I was going to school, and you know, I was like, you know what, I have my own art in my head that I kind of want to put onto canvas or walls or whatever. And I decided to grab a brush and start doing it, and I started getting good feedback, and with the help of social media and my friends and everyone and my family members, I got a pretty good following, and it started to affect the neighborhood, and people started contacting me for work slowly. And I was like, you know what, while I was going to Woodbury, I'm like, I think it's time for me to take the leap and try to make it a full-time thing. And I took a leave of absence just to like help my mom not freak out as much. I took a leave of absence on like a Friday, and then that weekend happened, and Tuesday I had a mural job. It was at a hookah lounge. And from that Tuesday to today, which is a good 5-6 years ago, I have not stopped working since. And right now I'm in Rancho Cucamonga painting this house. I got this little monster right here, and then I'm currently working on this guy right there. Pretty insane. And the main thing is, honestly, if within you, you know you have it, or you know you want to do something, just try it. You can't, no one can like take away your efforts to try, you know? Just try, see what happens, and just don't be afraid to show it. Whatever. If people don't like it, someone will. There's so many things to like, so many things to try. So go out there and see what happens. Show it, get feedback. And the cool thing is, like, I didn't all of a sudden come up with this in 2 seconds. This has been years, like years of work until I finally reached this design and like the calligraphy right here that I do based off the triangle. It took years of development getting to it, but I'm not exactly working towards it. I picked the subject matter, for example, like Greek gods, goddesses. This is Nike. So I went with them, and then I like this cloudy, contrasty look, so I went with that, and I started including my calligraphy. Just started adding on. It's still a little building blocks, you know? It's not all of a sudden, boom. Don't expect anything to be fast. It takes years of work. I did so much free work, like the first couple of years when I first started my career. It was insane. Now I'm six, seven years deep, making good money, but in the beginning, there was not the greatest, like, oh, here we go, millionaire. But it's great. As long as you're doing it for your own good, and you're not... You always push the boundaries, and you don't just do whatever it is that, like, you get to, don't limit yourself, is what I'm trying to say, you know, just go past it. This, those tiny efforts, the tiny details you put in between, that gets you the, like, the better jobs, and the opens up more doors within yourself and also into the world. Like, for example, like for this, like, I sent them a render, like I did the design, I showed them everything, I picked the colors, I sent everything, it's the tiny little details, and to earn their trust for me to do whatever I want. And that's the biggest thing, is when in art, whenever like people pay you for you to do whatever it is that you want. So that's me, Hybrid Sarkisian. My artist name is Demk, D-E-H-M-Q. You can follow him on Instagram if you want, or we can just chat and maybe meet one day once this COVID craziness is over. All right, peace out. Good luck, everybody.
Hi, my name is Spencer Nicholas, and I am in entertainment arts. My film for this year's Bash is titled Cavity, and it's an experimental abstract journey inspired by early MTV and Adult Swim using multiple mediums. This project was really rewarding and also very challenging due to the multiple mediums and all the editing it took, but at the end, I think it all came together, and I learned a lot about both stop motion and digital animation. In the future, I would like to pursue a career in the animation industry, either as a character designer or as a storyboard artist. And I hope you enjoy my film.
My name is Sochi Torres. I am a BHS alum, class of 2017, and I recently graduated from Cal State Long Beach, majoring in marketing and minoring in American studies. And just to tell you a little bit about my time at BHS and what I've been up to since then. So I was in Ms. Pickett's animation class my freshman year, and I remember being in that class with my best friend and how much fun we had collaborating on our projects together. I was also in Mr. Bentley's film production and photography class, and I was in Ms. Wynn's broadcast TV video production class. I don't know what it's called now, but I was able to film a lot of the school's live events, so dance shows, choir performances, or pep rallies. And I was also able to create my own short films, direct, write, shoot, and I had the opportunity to present some of them in film festivals, which was really exciting. And I always knew that I wanted to work in entertainment. My dad moved us out to Burbank, and every time we would drive by the studios, he would point at them and he would say, "Oh, there's so many opportunities here and the great things that you could do and create." So it was just inevitable that I would fall in love with this industry. So when I graduated, I was part of the Warner Brothers Reach Honorship Program, where I was granted 4 summers at the studio while I was in school. So while there, I interned at the Ellen DeGeneres Show, social media TV marketing, multicultural marketing for features, and lastly, Harry Potter global franchise. And while I was there, I learned that the studio slash corporate side are the ones who greenlight films and TV shows. They're the ones who make all the hiring decisions for directors, writers, cast. And one of the things that I loved about being on film sets, both in high school and in college, was being able to work and collaborate with other creatives, so the directors and the writers, and being able to get inside their minds and learn why they did things a certain way and more about their creative process. And I knew that if I wanted to continue seeing these stories on screen and more representation or authentic and accurate representation both on and off screen, I needed to be on the side that made those decisions. And so I decided to switch onto the corporate side, which is still creative in my opinion, but just in a different way. So that led me to my current role. I am at NBC Universal now, where I am part of a department called Global Talent Development and Inclusion. It's a really long title. but we give creatives opportunities and access into the studio system that they normally wouldn't have. And we do this through pipeline programs and initiatives for above the line and below the line. So directors, writers, composers, and I get to do exactly what I love doing on film sets, which is working with other creatives and trying to give them these opportunities and giving them resources and accessibility that they wouldn't have. And lastly, I just want to give some words of advice that I wish I would have known in high school, and that's to not compare yourself to other people. Imposter syndrome is a real thing, and I experienced that a lot in high school, college, and even to this day. I'm in meetings and I have no idea what's going on, but I pretend like I do. So I also just think now with social media, it's really hard seeing what other people are doing and feeling like you also have to be at that same level. I'm a freelance photographer, and that's one of my creative outlets. And I know that for me, seeing other photographers on social media post things, sometimes I feel like, oh, maybe I'm not good enough, or maybe I should be where they're at right now. Don't compare yourself to other people. Everyone is on a different path. They're all on their own journey, and you should be proud of where you are, because you're exactly where you need to be right now. And lastly, I just want to wish a congratulations to all the seniors. You've made it so far. Yay.
Congrats.
Congrats, Hannah. Woo!
We just wanted to let you know that we are so, so, so proud of you.
We know that you worked really hard and you spent a lot of countless nights being super tired working on your spooky film.
Yeah, but we're so impressed with how talented you are. And we know you're going to go really, really far with those talents. So keep at it. We want to wish you the best.
And you should keep in touch with us.
Yes!
Yeah.
Sending you lots of love.
One day we'll meet in person.
Hi, my name is Sierra Laksamore-Poku, but I go by Hannah. I am a student at BHS. I am currently in Animation 2. I made a film this semester called Mother's Project, and it's basically a story about a son coming back home, visiting his mom after a very long time being away from her and discovering what she has been up to. I got inspiration for this film and inspiration for the character, the mom character, after reading the case of Anatoly Moskvin and Ed Gein. I had a lot of issue while making the animation because I wasn't used to the program I was using for animating and editing. I also had troubles with perspective and camera angles, but my mentors, Crystal and Polima, helped me out a lot. They helped me refine my idea and helped me figure out which camera angle would best fit what expression or emotion I'm trying to portray. One of my goals for this film is to make the audience feel something while they are watching it, or leave a lingering feeling after the film is done. I also wanted to have an understandable storyline while still having it be a little complex. In the future, I hope to become an independent freelance artist who makes illustrations and publishes her own comics, whether it be digital or traditional. I also wish to be part of character designing for a video game. And that's basically it. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoy the film.
Thank you.
What's up? My name's Jacob. I was in Burbank High School's graduating class of 2017. And I was also in Miss Piggott's animation classes for each year that I was there. Some of you can probably relate, but Miss Piggott's class, sickest class there, is the best, hands down. I mean, I'm not knocking the other classes, they're cool, but Miss Piggott's class was just, it was good. So after I graduated, I was lucky enough to land an internship spot at Warner Brothers that I'd applied for earlier that spring. The deal was, if I went to a four-year university, they would let me come back each summer and intern on a different show. So I chose Cal State Fullerton as my school, and during the summers, I got to intern on shows such as Scooby-Doo, Wacky Races, and some of the DC animated movies. And that went on for about three summers. So the thing is, like, after my third semester at school, that's when it started to get a little, you know, school started to get a little shaky, a little tough, you know, school hard, brain tiny type deal. I realized I was learning more at my summer internship than I was at university. And that's not for everyone. Go to school. That's important. Don't be like me. Go to school. But for me personally, I just felt like I would rather be working than going to school. So during my last summer at Warner Brothers, thank God I had the opportunity to be there. I was really just looking for a job. I was asking all the people I met. I'm like, hey, y'all hiring soon? I can help out anyway. I'll clean your toilet, whatever. I'll mop your floor, blah, blah, blah. Luckily, some of the people I met, super cool. I interviewed for a position as an APM on DC Superhero Girls on Cartoon Network. I landed that gig, and I've been working full-time at Warner Brothers since 2019. So yeah, I've been working there full-time for almost 2 years now. For the better part of 6 or 7 months, I was actually physically in the office until last year when we all got sent home forever. Recently though, a few months ago, I got promoted to senior APM on the Tiny Toons reboot that they're working on. So that's cool. I'm still drawing as a hobby from time to time. Just living right now, waiting for this thing to end. I'm vaxxed, I'm ready to get back out there. So I'll show you where I've been working for almost the past year, locked inside. Here's my desk, is where I am most of the time. Giant cup filled with water, gotta stay hydrated. Work computer that I've been using, that gave it to me from the office, and I've been holding on to it to do work. My Cintiq for when I'm drawing, usually for hobby or for other people. Parking ticket, didn't pay yet, but I'm innocent. A lot of stuff on the wall, stuff that I like. Just surround yourself with inspirations and energy. You know, all that vibe type of stuff that the kids like to talk about. Yeah, like I said before, this class is amazing. If you didn't know that by now, then I don't know what you're doing here. But yeah, Miss Piggott's awesome. Nickelodeon's awesome for doing this each year, among other things. Some of the best memories I had were definitely through this class and through the programs that were offered. So they really shaped me into who I am now and set me up for what I'm doing. And my hats are off to all the students watching this, because you had to do it all from home, and that is not normal. You guys are special, and you guys should be proud of yourself. That's more than I ever had to do. I mean, I can barely go like 2 hours in my room. You guys are troopers. Anyways, congrats on the films. I'm so stoked to watch them. I really look forward to it. You guys should feel proud. I'm rooting for you. Y'all have bright futures ahead of you. So, peace.
Hi, I'm Riley Shea Redekin. I'm in Animation 2, and basically my animation is about a child whose mother is very controlling, and they just kind of have a negative relationship. I was extremely inspired by Kikuo's song, You're a Useless Child, which is basically about that. And I just was really inspired by the lyrics, and I've been such a big fan of his music for so long that I was like, you know what, I've been wanting to animate to his music forever, I'm gonna send him a message and see if it's okay, and he said yes, which was a big honor, and so here it is. Let's see, shout outs. I'd like to give a shout out to my mom, who's actually really nice. She's quite the opposite of the mother in the story. She was very supportive of me, and even when I didn't believe that I would be able to finish it on time, she hyped me up, and I'm very thankful for her. And some of my friends, thank you to my friends, thank you to my mentors, even though I left early, thank you so much, and thank you to Miss Piggott for being so patient. Of course, thank you. I know it's hard to work with me sometimes. Future goals and plans, I think I would love to either become a character designer or a comic book artist. I would really love to become a comic book artist. Challenges, where do I begin? Let's see. I think the hardest thing for me in it, like for the animation, was the walking cycles. There were a lot of them and I did not enjoy it. I really didn't. I just asked my mom. She got a lot of complaining from me. But I think it ended up looking really good, and I had a lot of fun with it, even though it was really hard. I'm so proud of it. And I really hope you guys enjoy. Thank you so much. Bye!
Hello, my name is Jordan Barlin, and I'm a junior at Burbank High School in Animation 2. My short I worked on this year is a stop-motion animation called Disparity. My goal for this animation was to create a very professional-looking movie that looks both smooth and unchoppy. I worked hard to create human movements with my main character. My animation is heavily inspired by stop-motion films made by Leica Studios and music videos done by the band Tool. For my animation, I also challenged myself to make an original score that fits well with the story. In my future, I'd like to be a stop-motion animator and work on scoring films. I'm really happy I got picked for the bash, and I hope you enjoy what I made. Thank you.
everyone, and welcome to my studio. My name is Adnay Kudafurdian, and I am a BHS alumni class of 2015. I'm a production assistant currently at Walt Disney Animation Studios, and I'm working on their upcoming feature, Encanto. But it's been a winding journey to get to this point. I've loved animation ever since I was 8 years old. I started when I would write and draw my own stories. They were pretty much spin-offs of the Winx Club at the time, but we all start somewhere. And I never really grew out of loving animation. In high school, I got my first opportunity to take an animation class with the lovely Miss Pickett. And in 2014, I was a part of the very first group of Nickelodeon mentorship ever, where I met my amazing mentor, who is an angel, and I still keep in contact with her to this day. I knew then that I wanted to go into the animation industry professionally, and I started in community college as an illustration major at COC, then PCC. I thought I wanted to go into visual development, but I ended up switching paths to a management major instead at Woodbury University. I graduated in 2021, but technically I finished classes in 2020. And I got my degree in business management with two minors in animation and professional writing. So, class of 2021, I feel you. Graduating during a pandemic was one of the most difficult things I think I've ever gone through. It's difficult in ways that I can't really verbalize. I didn't have anything lined up right out the gate because just months before, the world changed. And then, through some stroke of luck, or a miracle, or goodwill, or something, I landed a production internship at DreamWorks Animation on their upcoming movie, The Bad Guys. It was wonderful. It's gonna be a great movie. DreamWorks is full of fun and amazing people, and that position landed me here at Disney. It's been many highs and lows during this prolonged self-isolation. I definitely feel that. And my biggest advice to you all is don't worry so much about the path that you're taking to get there. If you love animation and the amazing people that are behind it pulling all the strings, if you are kind, if you are hardworking, it's not really a matter of if you're gonna get into the industry, it's just a matter of when. When I was younger, I didn't have any connections to the industry. None of my family worked in it. We didn't have any family friends that worked in it, and I found it difficult to reach out to people. I was scared that I was imposing. So I want to leave you all with this note, especially if you are an anxious person like I am. If you ever have any questions, if you feel lost, if you feel unsure about something in animation, to quote our sister studio, you've got a friend in me. Reach out and let's chat. Congratulations to you all for an amazing year and amazing work that you've done during very tough times and a lot of pressure. I'm looking forward to a bright future for you all, and I hope that you're excited for it too. See you!
Hi, I'm Kayleen Tran. I'm a senior at Burbank High School, and I'm in the senior focus class. My animation short is called That 70s Swing. It's about an honor student meeting his academic rival at a swing-themed dance party in the 1970s. These characters come from a novel I scrapped back in sophomore year. And I hope I can still continue the series in an animation series or comic format. For this animation in particular, I wanted to create an enemies to lovers dynamic while having a fun dance sequence to go along with it. In the future, I plan on majoring in international relations and becoming a potential researcher in history. I also want to do art in my free time and have these hobbies continue throughout my life. I hope you all enjoy the animation, and thank you for tuning in.
Yeah, but
That's step three.
Thank you for watching the 9th Annual Burbank High School Animation Bash. Keep creating!